Good morning. Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. It is so good to see you all. Hallelujah. In this new month, this new day, this new week, we praise God for a time of prayer. And we praise God for each and every last one of you that's coming in. We're in the month of April, the fourth month. Amen. Glory be unto God, which we're speaking creative miracles over our lives. Amen. Amen. So we just bless God for each and every last one of you all. Amen. We thank God for this new season, this new chapter in our lives as we continue to believe God like never before. Amen. So today is going to be powerful as we begin to prophesy. Today, the Lord wants you to be the prophet over your own house, the prophet over your own life. God wants you to prophesy over yourself. So today is going to be powerful. I pray that you be blessed by today's broadcast. God bless you all as you're coming in. God bless you all. The Spirit of the Lord is waking us up. He's waking us up, amen, to pray. And so we believe and we shall receive. If you believe, you will receive. Amen. Amen. God bless you. So listen, those of you who are coming on, good morning. Good morning, Kingdom citizens. Listen, share this video. Invite some people on. Those who may be looking for this page, can't find the page, share this video on your page. We ask that you become an evangelist. A lot of people don't understand the different titles in the body of Christ. Some people think the word evangelist is just for females because it sounds femaleish, but men can be evangelists. Evangelist is someone who goes out and spread the word of God. They go out and spread it. They're not stable in one spot. They're not stuck in one spot. They have to go out. And so an evangelist goes out. They go out into the world. They go out. They don't stay in one spot. They're not a pastor. A pastor stays and shepherds a flock of people in one spot. And so a lot of people don't really know what God has called them to do, you know? And so that's why you hear some people call themselves marketplace prophets, meaning they still got the gift of prophecy, but they still prophesy outside of the four walls of the church. They prophesy through how to make money. They prophesy they have creative ways to do God's will, and they understand the gifts of the Spirit. And so, yes, they may have a Fortune 500 company, but they're still a prophet. And people think only certain gifts are in the body of Christ, where it's in the four walls of the church, but you have to understand certain gifts. Certain gifts are there for a reason. So you want to understand that you can be an evangelist and share the good news of Jesus Christ. And if you're not going out knocking on the doors, not going out witnessing, not going to the jails, the prisons, and all those things, but these are things God wants us to do, amen, you can be an evangelist today because social media is so powerful. We're reaching so many people across this nation. And so you have an audience. I have an audience. And today, as you share this video, you know, the Bible says some plant, some water, but only God gives the increase. I'm going to say that again. God will use you. He'll use me. He'll use others, but only God will give the increase. So I basically just say this, God is using whoever he can to get the word to somebody. God is using whoever he can. So if you're prideful and you think only God can use me to reach certain people, you got to be kidding me, because he will use whomever he needs for people to get saved, delivered, set free. Amen. So listen, some plant, some water. What are your assignment in the kingdom? Are you the one that plants? Are you the one that water people? You water people with the word. but only God gets the increase. So that means God is using all of us in different capacities for his glory. It's all for his glory. So today we need to die to ourselves and make sure that we are, let thy kingdom come, let thine will be done on earth as it is in heaven. God bless you today. Good morning, Kingdom citizens. Thank you for sharing the video. God bless you for sharing. God bless you for sharing. I see so many of you all coming in from all over. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I feel a little rejuvenated today because the kids are on spring break. So I don't have to rush right after the service. Well, after this prayer service, I don't have to rush and rush them to school. Normally after these, I have to rush and get them to school, make sure they got breakfast. So after this live, I can kind of take a little break, amen, a little breather. But it's not too sunny here in Georgia. It was raining last night. So we, you know, can't really enjoy our little spring break with, you know, going outside, all that stuff. It's going to be a little rainy here today. And so we thank God for rest. Somebody say rest. Sometimes it's not about being busy. Sometimes you need that time of resting, resting. Yes, yes. Resting, resting, resting. So God bless you. Good to see you all. I'm excited about today. And you know what I was supposed to ask? Could you hear me? I'm assuming you all can hear me, and I'm excited about that. I have this shirt from our women's department at our my husband's father's church. They gave us these shirts for the women's conference. I believe it was called Believe. Yeah, and so I love little shirts that just represents the biblical views of Jesus Christ. All right. So I'm feeling excited about this new month of April, where we're going to speak some things today. So as I got up in prayer today, and we're about to pray, as I got up today to pray, Holy Spirit began to speak to me today. And he said, begin to teach people today in prayer to be the prophet of their own home. You know, certain titles scare people. Prophets, apostles, evangelists, teachers. You know, that's one of the major ones that people don't really, they kind of hide back from. A teacher, the fivefold ministry in the Bible. Apostle, pastors, evangelists, teachers, and prophets. And so that's the fivefold ministry. Now, most of the time, many of us, we will go to a church to experience the fivefold ministry. Listen, it's the body of Christ. God says you gotta experience all five. You're supposed to be experiencing all five. You're supposed to experience that apostolic and, you know, the apostle, the pastor. You know, it's just a lot that God wants to let you experience. But one thing about a prophet, God wants you to speak the word of God, speak the heart of God over your situation. And so there are people that's going to be tuning in from the replay or live on here now. And the Lord says that he wants to change the direction of your life. Oof, in this month of April, the Lord wants to change the direction of your life. You were going in one direction, but the Lord wants to change the direction and give you redirection. He wants to reshape your world. You know, I was talking to a young lady the other day, and she's been traumatized. And I told her something. I said, you need to experience reprogramming your life. And because she was traumatized, I said, you need to experience a reprogramming of your life. She said, how can I reprogram my life? And I'm around so many toxic people, and I'm around so many toxic things. And I said, you know what? Don't give that excuse that. And she said, in order for me to reprogram my life, I'm going to have to leave my situation and get away from everybody so I can start over. And I said, the devil is a lie. The devil is a lie. There are ways that you can reprogram your life without fully isolating yourself from everyone. And she said, how is that? And so you can start changing the way you think, changing the way you speak, changing the way you receive information, how you respond. There are a lot of people right now are aborting their destiny by bad attitudes. You know, there are different things the Lord will show me in prayer. It's your attitude that is going to help you in this situation. It may not be perfect, but if you have the right attitude, you can see me begin to maneuver you and shift you through this situation. So the Lord is going to give a lot of us redirection. He's going to help us to reprogram our minds. You know, when many of us, our mindsets have been programmed the way our parents have programmed us. Some of us have been in families that program us in fear, very fearful. Everything we do is, what if this gonna happen? What if this gonna happen? Some of our parents are like masters of fear and worry. Like they're just like you. Like when you get around certain parents, you have to tell them, look, mom and dad, cut the news off. Look, y'all worry about everything. You know, you got to be careful around certain people because they are stressed. You know, they are very stressful and they'll put stress on you. And if you don't be careful, they'll stress you out. Well, you better worry about that. Did you see the news? Did you see that? And did you see that? Yes, I'm not saying that I'm not considerate, but you got to be careful what you focus on, because what you focus on, you will become. Whatever you focus on, you will become. So today, the Spirit of the Lord is going to teach us how to continue to prophesy over our children. Are you prophesying over your children? Are you prophesying over your marriage? Now, many people have to repent for speaking ill of your family members, your children, your businesses. You know, you speak bad of your spouse. You speak bad of yourself. You speak, you know, I ain't gonna make it through this. You're speaking doom, and you don't even understand whether you're speaking good or bad. You're prophesying life or death over your situation. And I don't have time to go into it today, but I taught a little bit about this at One Glory Night about how you can speak. God says, bless people and not curse them. I'm going to let that linger a little bit. You can look that scripture up. I don't have time to pull it up before you because this is not in my notes. But the Bible says, he said, you can bless people. And he says, but I tell you not to curse them. That means that you can curse people. My God, my God. You can speak curses over people and people don't believe it. I don't care what they say about me. It don't matter what they say about me. The Bible says that's why you have to speak this one scripture. No weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against me in judgment, God, you shall condemn them. Because people do speak word curses. Somebody is speaking word curses over you. They may speak and say, your business will never succeed. They ain't gonna grow. But then when you start growing, it will shock the living daylights out of them. Why? Because you've learned the power of, I'm not ignorant. I'm biblical. I'm going to be all biblical. I'm not ignorant to Satan's devices. That means Satan has weapons that he will use against us to keep us limited, keep us living paycheck to paycheck. Why? Because there are Satan devices that's being launched out, and Satan has people he used to get to you. So you have to learn every morning to be the prophet of your house. That's the speaking gifts. There are different gifts that God puts on the inside of us, but prophecy is the speaking gift where you know, there are gifts of miracles, gifts of healings. There's the word of knowledge, all kind of things, all kind of gifts. But this particular gift that God is speaking over us today, you got to wake up in the morning and prophesy over yourself. Don't wait till a prophet come to prophesy. You have already been speaking this over yourself. You got to be so prophetic that you are not moved by what you see. Even though I don't see it, I'm going to speak things into existence. You got to get to a place where you begin to speak healing in your body to the point where your body just lines up and get healed. That's what the Lord wants us to do, is become the prophet of our home, the prophet over our children, the prophet over our finances, and begin to speak over ourselves, our day, over our situation. And the Bible says, when you begin to speak the word of God over yourself, prophesy the word of God over yourself, this is going to change the direction of your life. You was going in one direction. Now the Lord is going to lead you in a totally different direction. So change, if you want to change the direction of your life, start speaking the word of God. If there is no one coming to your business, you need to get up in the morning and speak the word of God. Speak and call forth clients, supernatural clients. It don't take a lot of people. Sometimes you need that one person. God can send one person that can change the trajectory of your life. I don't need a lot of people. Lord, send me the right people. That's your prayer this year. I don't need a lot of people. Lord, send the right people. Because you can have a lot of people, but the wrong one. It's been in the past, people will talk about how they prayed for a lot of people to come to their church, but they never could ever purchase the church. And people was like, but the church is filled. Don't be impressed by a lot of people. Are y'all meeting the budget? Are souls being saved? Is all the drama and the mess calmed down? Are y'all effective? Are you growing? Do people have testimonies? Me and my husband just said that now we're going to have to start having testimony services at our services. Why? Because when the ministry becomes fruitful, you will hear testimony. But if it's not fruitful, anything that's not fruitful is barren, is dead. And so you have more complaints than testimony. You have to not be impressed by crowds. God needs to send you the right people. Because God can do more with the right people than the wrong people around. The wrong people around will slow you down. It will hinder the anointing on your life. It will hinder you. You will be more, it's like you're more handicapped than anything. And so that's why we're on here today. We don't want to handicap you where you got to constantly keep texting. Can you pray for me? Can you pray for me? When are you going to pray for yourself? By now, somebody put that in the comment section. By now, you should be a prophet to the nations. By now, you should have your book of decrees. By now, you should be helping others. By now, you should be asking your church or your a community, a ministry, how can I help out and utilize my gift to help others? By now, you should be, hallelujah, one of the lead intercessors or one of the lead prayer warriors. Come on, somebody. It's called the body of Christ. By now, you should be operating in a greater capacity by now. But somebody has handicapped you. And I like the lady that I had a session with yesterday. She said, oh, I'm sounding just like you. I said, don't let the devil fool you. Some plant, some water. But it's God that gives the increase. That's what the devil wants us to think. Oh, I'm acting just like the woman of God. No, what is happening is we are imitators of Christ. God uses people to bring out our best in us. And many people, if you look at the life of Jesus, why did he have 12 men hanging around him? Then it ends up being 77. Why did he have so many people? Come on, when you read the Bible, it was more than 12 disciples. For those who read their Bible, you do know Jesus had more than 12 disciples. He was training up an army to replicate him. Come on. He was training up men to be imitators of him. And that's why Jesus, when he sent out the disciple and the disciples couldn't pray for the sick boy and they called for Jesus, what did Jesus say to them? How long? How long am I going to have to be with you? And so that's what my ministry is about. My husband's ministry is about. We are here to call people to do the greater works of Jesus Christ. It's not the body of Christ if we don't train and equip you that you should be able. If we go through a pandemic one more time or another pandemic, you should be able to go viral. You should be able to go in the woods and have church and begin to speak the word of God until your church open back up. You should be able to lay hands on the sick and the blinded eyes be open. You know, I mean, you should be able to hear the Lord and say, Lord, my iron is low. What should I take? What can boost my iron up like this? Because you can take this and that and it still won't correct it. But if you take this particular thing, it will boost your iron level. Come on, you got to understand how to hear the voice of God and maneuver in these times and seasons. Speaking the word of God can change the outcome of your situation. Start speaking the word this whole month and you speak creative miracles every day, it will change the direction of your life and the outcome of your situation. You change your world by speaking the word. You change your situation by speaking the word. So what God is going to do today is get you to think bigger. And he's going to release the power of God within you by speaking the word of God. Remember, God's spirit lives on the inside of you. And as you speak the word of God, you're going to see you speak the word over negative situations. If you're going through in your marriage right now, you better have a whole bunch of scriptures today to speak over your marriage. If your child is got anger towards you, you better speak the word of God on how to arrest that spirit that's manipulating your child in anger towards you. That's a spirit. Because let me tell you something. If you don't deal with that angry spirit, it'll start breaking stuff. It'll start tearing up stuff. It'll start cursing at you. And then one lady, I had to pray for her because her daughter jumped on her and fought her. So you better be careful just sitting there patty cating some of the stuff. Because you got to speak the word, because if you don't be careful, that thing can manifest into a giant and you look up, you can't even handle it. Counseling sessions are great, but you can't counsel out a demon. When I was younger, my mom would send me to a counselor and we all would sit there and it was like, tell me why my daughter is acting like this. And in the counseling session, I'm like, just had attitudes. Why did I have all those attitudes? I'm smoking now. I was introduced to smoking. I was introduced to drinking. I was introduced to men now. Now I'm sleeping around with different boys. I done opened the doorway to different demons. And I'm angry because my mama is trying to stop me from doing what I want to do, which now I'm rebellious. And when a child is rebellious, rebellion is in them, I don't care how much you try to talk kind to them. Baby, we sitting there planning our next move. We don't hear nothing you're saying. That's why when most people bring their daughters to me, you know, and all that stuff, and you can see in that, you can listen, when you're a real prophet, you can see, you can hear, I can look in your eyes and I can see the trauma. You can see and that's why some people, when they talk to me, they look the other way. I can look right in your eyes and see what's going on with you. And that's why when I have conversations with people, I say, listen, you better be careful when you talk to me, because I hear something more than what you're saying. I can hear the sarcastic. I can hear things. And that's when I pull away and pray. Because Jesus said he was walking with Peter. One minute Peter was walking in the Spirit of God. Then the next minute, Satan gets in him. You got to identify when Satan gets into people. You'll be like, that ain't so-and-so who's talking right now. A demon's just enter in. Just that fast. Jesus said, what you just said, Peter, the Spirit of God just said that to you. Then Peter kept running his mouth. And then he said something, and Jesus said, Satan, get out of him. Come on. See, if many of us would walk with Jesus, if Jesus come back on this earth and walk, he'll offend a lot of us. Was you just saying Satan is in me? Because he saw that. One minute you speaking, you walking in the Spirit. Then the next minute you speaking what Satan is telling you. No. And all of us, we have to resist what Satan is saying. He's speaking to all of us. And you got to say, I'm not on your team. So I'm not going to let me utter this thing out of my mouth. All right. So when I went to the counseling sessions, my mom couldn't get me to respond after you pay. See, when you don't deal with devils, you're going to spend a lot of money. You'll stay broke spending. Listen, don't be impressed by all these people who got all this money. Half of them spend a lot of money in sessions. And so I'm sitting in this session, and nothing ever changed. I literally got worse. I got worse. Till one day my mama told me, she said, Jackie, I couldn't take it. I couldn't take it no more. She said, you was going crazy. My oldest son was going crazy. She said, my marriage was going. She said, it was like a whirlwind hit her life and she didn't know what to do. She said, she packed up everything and put us on the road, sent us to South Carolina. And a lot of people don't like me to tell the story because they're like, you giving credit to your daddy family. You giving credit to your daddy's side of the family. It don't matter who had the audacity to speak to that spirit that was harassing me. And in this time, it's not about credit. Mama side, daddy side. It's about who had, hallelujah, the boldness to speak to a teenager and said, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Who had the boldness to say, listen, I ain't taking you to no counseling session. We're going to cast this spirit out. Come on, somebody. See, some of us, we spending all this money buying your daughter new weave and hair and stuff like that. It's not going to fix it. Oh, just be nice to her. Be nice to him. That ain't going to help it. It's going to continue to open up doors that you got to speak to the spirit. So what you got to do is do more praying for your family than anything if you see a negative situation. So when my mama dropped me off at my grandmama's house, my daddy's mom, she didn't have time to be my friend. She said, listen, we go to a Pentecostal church. You ain't wearing jeans. I had no choice but to obey what this lady said. Because if not, I will be in the homeless shelter or in the foster system or something. So listen, at this age, I'm going to just follow what she said. She said, now look, get up. We're going to get you some clothes. Because you know how we were young? Listen, I had them tight jeans on. You know, young people like to dress. I had them tight stuff on. She said, you ain't wearing that around me. You going to put on a dress when you come with me. But when I had to go other places, I put my tight stuff on or whatever. And then she said, the Lord told me to put anointing oil on your head for 7 days. And she would come and she said, come here, come here. She put that oil on my head and she lay hands on me and prayed for me. She said, we're going to break this spirit off of you. See, some of you all think it's going to happen in one day. I took my baby to church today. I took them to Easter service today. Baby, it's going to take more than an Easter service. You got to drive some devils out. And it's deep in your bloodline. Because if that suicidal demon couldn't, if that suicidal spirit didn't get your family, it's coming for your grandchildren. Y'all don't want, and y'all just sitting there eating, but you sitting there eating all day. Why are you eating and you got a demon of suicide that runs in your family? Well, I guess if we don't talk about it, it's not going to hit my, that's not how spirits work. You got to go in the spirit realm and arrest these spirits so they won't attack your next bloodline. If you got premature death running rampant in your bloodline, why are you sleeping? Why are you not up at 5 o'clock in the morning praying? You sleep too much and the devil have his way all up in your family. And then all you do is he makes you victims, victims, victim, victim. And then you talk on the phone with people who have no track record. All they do is run their mouth. They don't give you no results. And you wonder why you in the divorce court. This is your third marriage. Come on, somebody, because you're hanging around people that doesn't give you victory. No reason in the world you don't have no overflow. You're supposed to be in overflow right now. More than enough. Cancer and tumors and stuff running rapid in your family, eating too much sugar. All the stuff that is just clogging you up and you trying to figure out, why do I feel sick? I don't have any energy and this, this, and that, and this, this, and that. And God is sending warnings after warnings. Get work on your health. Drink more water than you drink anything else. In this earth, yes, you have the Spirit of God. But on this earth, you're going to really have to hear the Spirit of God concerning your health. Because if the Satan can't get you with drugs and alcohol, he's going to kill you early in your health. And right now, he's already starting to slowly kill you by what you put in your mouth. What you eat is killing you. Well, I just love God. But let me tell you something. You can love God, but certain things are triggering heart attacks. If you know it runs in your bloodline, you're going to have prayer to counsel some of these things and silence. Put this in the comment section. My job is to silence the voice of the enemy that's speaking in my family. My job is to silence it. Have you silenced the voice of the enemy that's speaking over your family? Have you silenced poverty? Have you silenced it? If not, it's still speaking. These are evil altars. That's still speaking. Your mama couldn't handle it. Your daddy couldn't handle it. Your grandfather couldn't handle it. Your grandmama couldn't handle it. Now here you are, the next generation. Can you handle it? So instead of complaining about your situation, speak only the word of God and not your feelings. Too many people are speaking their feelings and not the word of God. And before you go out here and try to be a wonder, I'm a prophet to the nation. I just told you to prophesy over yourself. But before you take on why are so many people giving up, logging off social media, First, they said it was a preacher. Now, they ain't no preacher no more. First, they said God called them to business. Now, they done shut the business down. Why are you not stable? Why you don't have an anointing of preservation, consistency? Why don't you have that anointing? Because a lot of people have stepped in certain arenas and areas and positions that God never graced you, anointed you, anointed your head to do. What do you mean by that, woman of God? You jumped out there and tried to have a business conference knowing that you wasn't even graced to teach people about, don't talk about something you haven't first lived. Put that in the comment section for the people who gonna watch the replay. Because they may not, I don't think my mic is on. Somebody picked at me Sunday. I don't think my mic is on. I don't think you can hear me clear enough. Don't preach about something you haven't lived. Come on. Don't talk about something you haven't lived. Don't talk about something you haven't lived. Well, how am I supposed to preach the Bible about finances if I ain't got no finances? Then ask God to make you wealthy. And you do know there's different levels. Rich, poor, wealthy. Just because you're rich don't mean that the money, you got to understand, poor, rich, and wealthy. You want to be wealthy. A wealthy person has taken their money and created systems. They will never be broke. A rich person just have a lot of money. They don't have systems. If the boss or whoever called them tomorrow and said, we can no longer pay you, they go back to poor. So it's not about having a lot of money. It's about creating systems. Take the money you have and invest in different things. That's why you got to invest in yourself. Don't talk about something you haven't lived. Because Satan will come with open shame and shame the mess out of you. Stop out here trying to act like you a prophet and you laying hands on people. Can I lay hands on people? Can I lay hands on people? And keep on doing it. And if God haven't graced you to do it, and you be sleeping, you sleeping at night, and then some demon come knock at your door, you be like, what is that? What's all the strange activity in my house? Why in the world are my children acting funny? Why do I feel sick? All of a sudden I feel sick. Because you didn't pray properly before trying to kick out devils. You mean tell me you're going to go in Satan's camp and kick out devils, but you didn't cover yourself. Never. Before you pray for others, put a wall of protection around you before you go out. Put a hedge of protection around you. Father, I'm going out to pray for the sick. I put a blood hedge of protection around me. That's why if you look at most people who go on mission trips, those who didn't pray properly end up coming down with sicknesses and illnesses. Everybody's not called to go to the nation. When I went to Europe, the pastor stopped me and he said, have you been called to Africa yet? Or, you know, these other countries yet? I said, no, this is the furthest I've been. He said, well, then God knows what he's doing because he's preparing you. God will never send you on a mission that he knows you're not ready for. He said, do you know why you got to be prayed up to go to certain levels and do mission work? He said, in certain parts of Africa, he said, you're not even supposed to drink the water, the bottled water there. They done put witchcraft in it. He said, did you know that? I said, no. He was just telling me the level of witchcraft. He said, there are certain people you can't even eat with. They will put witchcraft in your food, spells on your food. And if you carry the spirit of fear, if you constantly worry about what people say about you, you ain't ready for the nations to pray for others. because you can't even see you can't even see the witchcraft. And that's how some of them end up in the hospital, can't die until certain people who have the prophetic gift that can hear, rebuke the spirit of death, rebuke this, rebuke that. And then they recover. I'm not trying to scare you and make you seem like, oh, I can't do God's will. I'm trying to show you that don't do something until you have lived it. You live the life of, okay, I can conquer now spirits in my home. So I'm ready now to conquer it at the church. Okay, Pastor, you can make me a prayer warrior now. Well, how can he ever make you a prayer warrior if you're not trained? Do you come to the training services? You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm trying to show you. Before you jump out here, that's why a lot of people are giving up, because they jump in territories that they were never graced for. God called me to do a women's conference. God called me to do a women's conference. God called me to do a marriage conference. You better be careful. Did he really call? That's why this boy walks up to me and he said, I'm a prophet. I said, you sure? Are you sure? I looked at him like this. I said, are you sure? He said, yeah. I ain't seen him no more on social media. I hadn't seen him since. When the devil gets through with you, we'll see if you're still a prophet. After you get tried and tested, read the Bible, how them demons beat that boy up because he wanted to lay hands on people. Read this. I'm not making this stuff up. He said, can I pay for the anointing? The disciple rebuked him and said, the gifts and callings, we don't pay for this thing. Either you got it or you don't. And then he saw them laying hands on people. He said, I'm going to do it too. And that demon beat him up, beat that man up. There are spirits that are that strong that will beat the mess out of you. That if you don't know how to speak to, like, you got to have authority when you deal with certain things. You better be careful. Did God tell you to do a marriage conference? Do you have the grace to it? Because let me tell you something. If God called you to do a marriage conference, are you ready for your marriage to be attacked? Or will you look at your spouse and fight your spouse and not see that this is only attacking you because you're about to help other marriages? Do you get what I'm saying? So that means you and your spouse got to grab hands like daily. We come again, we put a blood hedge of protection around us. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. In the name of Jesus, Lord, cover this marriage because the enemy is trying to take us out because you're about to affect some other marriages. And you call yourself, you know, I'm called to do any kind of conference, anything you're called to help others. Baby, you better pray morning, noon, and night until that conference is finished. You got to have a lifestyle of prayer. You don't stop praying until the assignment of that thing is over with. You get all kinds of strange attacks. In the past, previously, I would do conferences and I would pray just one little fast. Baby, we would have people inbox us. One lady inbox, my husband and I, we're on the way to the conference. We're on the road. All of a sudden, strange sicknesses hit him, throwing up. She said he was throwing up like never before. She said, we had to pull over side of the road. She said, it got so worse. She thought she had to rush him to the hospital. She called me back and she said, woman of God, give my ticket to somebody else. I paid for the day session, but we can't come. I said, what's happening? She said, give my ticket to somebody else. We're going to have to turn around. I got a hotel room, everything. My husband will not stop throwing up. She, on her way to our conference, they turn around. She said, all of a sudden, woman of God, as soon as I get back home, he better. You have to understand that you don't stop praying until a whole project is finished, because all kind of things will come against you to stop the purposes of God. So I say all this today, pray over yourself before you pray for others. Put a firewall of protection around you, your children, your health. Because if the enemy can't get you, he's going to get anything else that's close to you and that is open and exposed to the enemy. And stop complaining about how bad your situation is and speak the word over it. Stop complaining about how bad it is. Speak the solution to that problem. So today, the Lord told us to be the prophet over our home, and we're going to do this for the month of April. So let's begin to speak creative miracles over ourselves, and then we're going to speak some scriptures of ourselves. All right, come on. I want you to begin to tell God thank you today. Let's begin to go into it. Come on, just wait as the Lord is waking many up. Hallelujah. And in all these stories I begin to tell you, glory be to God, is just showing you, hallelujah, how my mom took me to a counseling session and I got worse. But when she took me to a prophet, which my grandmama was a prophet, the Bible says people got delivered because of a prophet. You can get delivered. Prophets can deliver you out of bondage. And so when my mama takes me to a prophet, all this lady does is pray over me, put oil over me, and then I begin to get saved at 16 years old, all from being connected to a prophet. Come on, being connected to someone that wasn't impressed by how I look, wasn't impressed by this, but knew how to speak to devils and command them devils she drove those devils out. Amen. She didn't counsel the devil. She didn't patty cake the devil. Oh, you're going to be all right. No, she said, come in. Come in. We ain't going to talk. Come in. Come in. Oh, see, look, even in my house, when I see my children acting up, I said, come in. Or what oil? We put that oil on it. We dry these devil out because I already know what tormented me. And you're not going to torment my children. You got to stop letting these devils torment you and get that oil and dry. Come in. Come in. Mom, I feel depressed. Come in. Let me get the oil. They're taking them to the doctor and all that. Let me stop that. Okay, you do what you need to do. But let me tell you something. If you want to see results, come bring them to one of our services. Because, you know, all this stuff, it's taking years for you to see freedom. And all. No, we drive that out. We speak peace in the name of Jesus. Sometimes you need the oil just to be laid on your head in the name of Jesus. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, speak. Come on, we drive. It may take some time. But we're going to drive this thing out in the name of Jesus. Amen. You can do what you want to do. You go to the doctors, all that stuff. But you may need to get a second opinion, in which that is to drive some spirits out. And, you know, I already know some people going to come and stop telling people not to do that. Stop. I didn't tell you not to do nothing. Please don't say the woman God told me. No. Do what you want to do. Go get your. And then you need reports and stuff from the doctor. So we can see. Hallelujah. This is what the doctor said. But whose report do we believe? We believe the report of the Lord. And doctors are here for a reason. Amen. Sometimes I go to the doctor for them to show me, hey, do you see anything so I can pray against it? All right. So let's begin to tell God, thank you, God. We thank you today. Hallelujah. Glory be unto God. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. Have your way in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit. Today we will speak declarations over ourselves. We're going to prophesy over ourselves. Let's prophesy over ourselves. Deuteronomy 28 and 13. The Lord makes me the head and not the tail, and above and not beneath. I want you to prophesy over yourself as you go forth today. The Lord is making you the head, not the tail. No more at the bottom. But the Lord is making me the head. No more the tail, no more the bottom. I'm no longer at the bottom in ministry. I'm no longer at the bottom in business. I'm no longer at the bottom financially. I'm no longer at the bottom in my family. The Lord makes me the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. I break this off of me in the name of Jesus. And I speak in Deuteronomy 28 and verse 13. Hallelujah. The Lord makes me the head and not the tail. Not only I'm, hallelujah, walking above the enemy and I'm not beneath him, but it also for my children, also for my marriage. Lord, do this for our ministry. Lord, do this for our children. Lord, do this for us in the name of Jesus. Let's go forth. Begin to pray that the Lord makes you the head and not the tail in every area of your life. I will be the head and not the tail. I will be above and not beneath. Deuteronomy 28 and 13. I will always be at the top. I will always be at the top. Come on. Some of you all, you're always at the bottom. You're always the last one to be picked. You're always, come on. No, the devil is a liar. I will always be at the top. I will always be at the top and never below, never at the bottom in the name of Jesus. I will always be at the top in every area of my life in Jesus' name. Pray that through in the name of Jesus. Nehemiah 8 and 10, I will not be sad or depressed. I will not be sad or depressed. I break sadness, that spirit of sadness, depression off of me, off of my children, off of my spouse, off of those who are connected to us in the name of Jesus. I will not be sad or depressed because the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. I walk in the joy of the Lord. Let the joy of the Lord flow through me, flow out of me in the name of Jesus. And I'm a light for Jesus. That means wherever I go, I'm contagious. Lord, and come on, you got to be contagious for Jesus, that when you go places, that people don't rub off on you, you rub off on them. And that don't let people rub their sadness off on you, their depression off on you. You rub your joy off on them. I'm joyful. You can't take me down. You can't pull me down because I'm joyful. The joy of the Lord is my strength. I operate in it. I walk in it today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be unto God. Deuteronomy 28 and 6. I am blessed coming in and blessed going out. I want you to speak the blessings of God over you. Come on, prophesy over your day. Speak the blessings of God over you right now. I am blessed in the city. My life is blessed. My home is blessed. My finances are blessed. My marriage is blessed. I am blessed. I'm not cursed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed coming in. I'm blessed going out. I'm blessed in my city. I'm blessed on my job. I'm blessed. Come on, declare the blessings of the Lord. My health is blessed. My organs are blessed. My mind is blessed. My heart is blessed. Everything I touch is blessed. The blessings of the Lord is overtaking me. I am blessed. I am blessed. Speak the blessings of the Lord upon you. Speak the blessings of the Lord upon you. In the name of Jesus, glory be unto God. Philippians 4 and 13. And it declares, I can do all things through Christ who gives me the strength. In the name of Jesus, I can do it. I can do everything God has given me the strength. I can do it. I can conquer this. I can do it. Whatever God is telling you to do, you declare it today. I can do all things. I can do it. I can do it. I can do all things through Christ. I can conquer this situation. We can pay this debt off. Hallelujah. We can be owners of things. We'll do God's will debt free. I can do it. I can accomplish God's will. And I will do it with the strength of the Lord. I can have a good marriage. I can do all things. I can have successful children. I can do it. There are people that will come to remind you. You do know that your children, they supposed to be angry at this particular time. The devil is a liar. Come on, you got to silence devils. Come on, I told you there are people that carry spirits that will come and remind you of that they work for Satan. And they'll come to remind you, they're monitoring spirits. They'll come and try to check on you and your family and see, is this happening? Because it happened to you, don't mean it's going to happen to me. I can do it. I can have children that serve the Lord in the name of Jesus. I silence whatever the enemy is doing in the name of Jesus. Any influence the devil have over my children, I rebuke it now in the name of Jesus. Don't be moved by what you see, because it's going to be a turnaround. Remember, the enemy tries to fight before he can, because he knows that if they ever wake up to the promises of God, they will be a world changer. We can do it. We can do it. We can do it. We can do it in the name of Jesus. God has not, 2 Timothy 1 and 7, 1 and 7, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. I'm not walking in fear. I break the spirit of fear now in the name of Jesus. Fear torments, and I will not be tormented by the devil. I break the spirit of fear over my life to do business, to do ministry, to do what God has called us to do, to walk in a certain level financially where the enemy doesn't want us to walk in. I rebuke that spirit of fear. I speak to that mountain. I speak to that stronghold in the name of Jesus, and I command it to be removed. Isaiah 41:10, I will not fear because my God is with me. I will not fear because my God is with me. We will not fear any viruses. We're not fearing sicknesses. We're not fearing struggles. We're not fearing lack because God is with me. God, you promised me that you will never leave me nor forsake me. So I stand on that. Isaiah 41:10, my God strengthens me and helps me. God, thank you for helping me. I will be marvelously helped by God this year. God is helping me. He's helping the business. He's helping us financially. He's helping me. Pray for the help of God today. Lord, help me. Lord, help my mind. Lord, help me in my health. Lord, help me to see recovery. Lord, give us total recovery. Lord, help us, oh, for wherever the cankerworm and the palmerworm and the caterpillar has eaten up, Lord, help us to recover all. Lord, give us total restoration. Lord, let us help us to see creative miracles this month. Lord, help us. Lord, give me creative miracles. Give my husband creative miracles. Give our children creative miracles. Then you name each child. See, listen, I pray a lot. So I done called my children's name out, but I want you to call out each children and call out their names and say, Lord, give them creative miracles in their academics. Give them creative miracles in their health. Give creative miracles over my grandchildren. Give creative miracles over our homes, our properties, to pay it off. Lord God, give us creative miracles from renting to owning. Give us creative miracles, Lord God. Hallelujah. To do supernatural things, God. Give me a creative miracle to do things that is hard for others. Things that's hard for others, Lord, make me a sign and a wonder and give me creative miracles, Lord God, this month to do things that look impossible. Lord, make me a sign. Make us a wonder for your glory. Hallelujah. That will draw people to Christ. Lord God, for your name's sake, I don't want the credit. I want to do God's will in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be unto God. God is helping us. God is helping us. 1 Peter 2:24, by his stripes, I'm healed. By his stripes, I'm healed. Point blank period. By his stripes, I'm healed. I speak to all spirits of infirmity to go in the name of Jesus, and I command healing to flow, sickness go. I speak healing to my digestive system, healing to my organs, healing to my brain, healing to my vision, healing. May the Lord show you different things to eat so you can get your vision back. I rebuke blindness in the name of Jesus. And I declare, hallelujah, that the Lord will make you whole, that the Lord will make you whole in the name of Jesus. I speak healing in my body now. Anybody that's sick now, receive. Hallelujah. This is an atmosphere of miracles. Receive your healing now in the name. Lord, heal me. Lord, heal me. By the stripes of Jesus Christ, you said I'm healed. So I receive my healing now. I'm already healed. I'm healed in every area of my life. Not only you asking for healing in your body, but Lord, heal my marriage. Lord, heal my children. Lord, heal them in their mind. Lord, heal us from this generational curse. Lord, heal us from poverty. Lord, heal our finances. Lord, heal. There are different areas. Heal me in this financial journey. Heal us, God, in this entrepreneur journey. Heal the conference. Heal, God. We speak healing in every area of our lives where you need to see healing at. Just declare healing in the name. Nothing will stop this joy, our peace. I break that destructive spirit in the name of Jesus. All right. Matthew 5:14. I am the light of the world. Hallelujah. God, let your light shine through me. Let your light shine in over our business. Let your light shine over our church. Let your light shine over our ministries, our business. Let your light shine upon our children. Let your light shine, come on, upon our marriage. You speak that the light of God begins to shine. When God's light shine on you, you can't be hidden. You can't fail because God is shining his light. Prophesy over yourself. I can't be hidden. The light of God shines upon me. I can't go under. The light of God shines upon me. I can't stay sick. The greater one lives inside of me. The light of God is shining over us in the name of Jesus. This is what I want to prophesy, and we're about to end, is that your needs, your daily needs shall be supplied. Your daily needs to be supplied this month. Since we start off at the beginning of the month, many people, I rebuke late fees. I rebuke insufficiency in the name of Jesus, that your bills will be paid on time. Before even the 15th of the month, you have overflow. Speak that before the 15th of each month, I have overflow. That means everything is paid on time. I speak that you got to prophesy this. Everything is paid on time. And then by the 15th of each month, you are bringing in overflow. I prophesy that your savings account will start increasing. Your savings account is going to increase so that you won't even need a credit card. Your savings account will be a credit card. Everything you would do it debt-free in the name of Jesus. I break off the spirit of poverty off of every person that the enemy has his hands on your finances. When God calls you to do things, you can't do them because you don't have overflow. When God calls you to go and help others, you can't help others because you don't have overflow. When you're standing at the red light and you see that mother holding that sign and you say, Lord, I wish I could help her, but I don't have overflow. I declare in the name of Jesus that this strange season you was in, it comes to an end. Your winter season is over. Hallelujah. You shall spring forth into, hallelujah, supernatural wealth. I pray for the supernatural, supernatural wealth. May it comes upon you. Supernatural increase. May it comes upon you. Supernatural overflow. May it comes upon you. And the Lord says, now, when I answer this, don't you forget me. The Lord says, when I answer you, see, sometimes when the Lord, when you pray for things and the Lord gives you overflow, the first thing people do is spend it on a vacation. The Lord said, you ain't going on no vacation until I eradicate that those debts over your life. Come on. You ain't stop spending all this money until the Lord stable you, establish you. Sometimes when we get money, the first thing we do, we blow it. Lord Sakatalalaba, break that off of them in the name of Jesus. Today, I pray that your needs, your daily needs will be supplied. He said, daily, I will meet your needs. I want to speak that over you today in the name for the month of April, that it will overflow into the month of May. Come on. April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, 2024, December. At the 31st, you will still be in overflow. It will be ridiculous. And many of you will testify. And I can't wait to hear some of you in the mic will testify. When the woman of God spoke over my life, overflow, I have been experiencing overflow to the point where I can help others, not just myself, but I can help others. And I can do God's will and not go into debt and not hurt my family because it's a God move. God's will, God's bill. God's will, God's bill. God has been showing me as I do his will, he meets the bill. In the name of Jesus, I pray for supernatural supply, for daily needs. In the name of Jesus, I speak over you, Luke 6:38, I give and I shall receive, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. He's going to cause men to pour over into my bosom. I declare a running over anointing. Luke 6:38, he said, running over. When you give, the Lord will make sure you run over. I rebuke every spirit that is trying to stop the running over anointing. I declare run over. I will run over in favor. I will run over in
healing. Our run is running over. What God is doing in my life is running over. I have so much, I can't contain it. Hallelujah. I gotta help others because it's running over. Lekata lalabo. Lekata. I declare a running over anointing. Speak it over your life today. I'm running over with favor. I'm running over with increase. I'm running over. Hallelujah. Glory be unto God. Hallelujah. I'm running over. Lekusakatala. After you pay your bills for the month of April, you will see the running over anointing. Lord, let them know that you don't play. Let them know that you are man of your word. Let them see as they believe, they shall, every person that believe, let them receive it. Let them receive it in the name of Jesus, a running over anointing. I speak Deuteronomy 28 verse 12 over their lives. We are lenders and not borrowers in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is one spirit you got to break off of you, that the Lord makes you a lender and not a borrower. See, a lot of people don't like the scripture. I had to fight with one person about the scripture. They love God, but they say they like borrowing. I said, listen, the Lord says you're not supposed to borrow. Come on. He said you're supposed to lend. He says, I'm going to make you the bank this year. In the name of Jesus, Lord, whatever stronghold, whatever mountain that's in my way, in the name of Jesus, that's speaking to me, that's telling me that I can't lend. Today, in the name of Jesus, I declare I'm a lender. I'm a lender. I will be a lender this year. I will lend to people and not borrow. I will lend. I will lend to people and not borrow. That means everything I will do this year, I will do God's will, debt free. In the name of, I will not need to borrow to get the home. I will not need to borrow to get the car. I will not need to borrow to send my child to school. I will not need to borrow for my academics. You better speak it, because there are a lot of people that are borrowing, but the Bible says in, hallelujah, glory be unto God, Deuteronomy 28 and 12, the Lord says, this is the month I want to do creative miracles. You got, listen, if I don't see it, I will wait. I will wait upon the Lord till my faith get to that level, that I will not have to borrow, that I will be a lender. Lord, make me a lender. Lord, make me a lender. I can't wait to see that day. I can't wait to walk in it. I'm walking in it now by the power and the glory of Jesus. I don't owe no man but to love him. In the name of Jesus, Philippians 1 and 6, it says, I know that he who has begun a good work in me will complete it. God says, I have done the work in you. Now you shall see the completion. I speak completion. I prophesy completion. Every project that God told you to do, may you see the completion. Everything that God told you to do, may you see the house be completed. May you see the car completed. May you see the things that God has called you to do, academics completed. He says, I have begun a good work in you, and you will see the completion. This is the year to see things be completed. In the name of Jesus, you did it. I did it. I did it. Hallelujah. By the grace of God. And we completed it in the name of Jesus. I love the scripture. Philippians 4 and 6. It says, be not anxious for nothing. Be not anxious for nothing. Oh my goodness. I thank God for what you called me to do, but I ain't going to be anxious for it. I ain't going to be anxious for friendships. I ain't going to be anxious for a mic. I ain't going to be anxious to preach. I ain't going to be anxious to prophesy. So many people are so anxious to prove to people that they are prophets. So they just be like, oh, the Lord said, the Lord said, the Lord said, the Lord said, the devil is a liar. Jesus said he only did what his father told him to do. If he ain't speaking, I ain't saying nothing. Glory be unto God. Just because people are nice to you and they're not prophesying don't mean they're not a prophet. Be anxious. I'm not going to be anxious. Hallelujah. To prove that I got money. Too many of us, the reason we are in a hurtful place right now, because we was too anxious to prove to social media that we had money. Now your well done dried up. But I rebuke that in the name of Jesus. See, when you are anxious and you prove to people, look at me, I'm successful. Look at me, I'm this. Look at me, I'm this. And now you're suffering in a season, glory be unto God, by being too anxious. But this is the season we will not be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, I will let my request be known unto God. If you begin to thank God for what you have, hallelujah, and begin continue to pray and everything, glory be unto God, you will see God continue to remove the anxiety. Thank you, Lord, for what you are doing in in my life. He removes the anxiety. Thank you, Lord, for helping me. He removes the anxiety. Thanksgiving removes the anxiety. The anxiety, you know, to compare yourself. The anxiety to compete with others. The anxiety. I don't have nothing to prove. Put that in the comments. We have nothing to prove. When you are born again believer, you already won. When you compete with Christians, what you're doing is competing with someone who's already won. We have already won. I have nothing to prove. God has already done it. It's already done. I'm just doing God's will. I'm just doing you. Come on. Many of us, that's all we doing. We just doing God's will. I'm not out here to be a wonder. I'm not out here trying to prove a point. But what I will do is testify of his goodness. Come on. Don't let the devil hold you back. Well, your testimony sound like you bragging. The devil is a liar. I ain't got nothing to prove, but I will testify that God has done it. Hallelujah. I will testify so somebody else can see if God did it for me, he can do it for you. But I ain't got nothing to prove. Whether you believe God or not, he still did it. Hallelujah. But all glory goes to God, and I'm not going to be anxious for nothing. And I leave this over everyone today. Philippians 4:7. Let the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. I speak peace. Peace. I want you to pray for peace. Peace over your family. Peace over your business. Peace over your health. Peace. May the Lord give you peace. May the Lord give you peace. Pray for peace. Peace. There are some people, they preach, but they don't have peace. There's some people, they're doing business, but they don't have peace. There's people that got a whole husband right beside them in the bed, and they still don't have no peace. There's men that got beautiful women in the bed right beside them, don't have no peace. You got to be kidding me. You got a whole mansion, and you jealous of everybody. You know something the Lord revealed to me the other day? He said he had me to see all these people who was successful, and they still was proving a point. They had 6 and 7 churches and still on social media proving points. These people have mansions and still out here proving points. These people got a nice spouse, beautiful family, and they still out there proving a point. They working on degree number 5 and they still on social media, still proving a point. And that's when the Lord told me, he said, Jackie, all the stuff that you desire, they got it and still trying to get people to accept them. How is it that I'm just ministering at one church and you got 5 and you still not fulfilled? Do y'all get what I'm saying? How is it that I only have 1 degree and you got 4 degrees? And you still trying to get people to accept you. You still deal with rejection and you got everything. How is it that you got everything? And how is it that some of us are renters? We still renting. We can't wait to purchase our house, but you own your house and you still not happy and you own your house. God says, if you can see that people still out here trying to prove a point, people been in ministry for years, still wanting people to accept them. How in the world you are over all these businesses and you're fiending for people to love you and accept you? I speak peace over you. Don't be moved by what you see. Everybody, it ain't what you think it is. It ain't what you think it is. People driving nice cars and still out here proving a point. The reason they're proving a point is because somewhere the enemy has told them they may lose their security. So I speak peace over your life. In the name of Jesus, I speak peace. Peace. I want you to pray for peace as we get ready to leave. Lord, I speak peace over my business. I speak peace over my marriage. Lord, give me peace.
Give me perfect peace. Pray for peace. Pray for peace. Pray for peace. Lord, give us supernatural peace. Give us supernatural peace in the name of Jesus. Give us supernatural peace in the name of Jesus. That I don't be weary of while doing God's will. Give me peace while I preach. That I don't feel like I got to compare. And one of the ways you can tell people are not praying and they're in competition with everybody, because everybody copying, they look the same, they dress the same, they act the same, they doing the same thing. If you ever notice my ministry, I do exactly what God tells me to do. I do 5 a.m. prayer. You don't see me out here going live in the morning, the noon, the night. Do you notice if you see a consistency with my ministry? I only do what God tells me to do. I do know if I go live at certain times, I can go viral. Because everybody don't, you have to be called by God to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning to pray. Everybody not getting up at 5 o'clock. My views will go up tremendously when I go live at a later time. But I heard the Lord say, you go live at 5 a.m. And I have peace. I have peace. I have peace that the God who called me, he will see it to completion. Stick with the one who called you. Put that in the comment section. Stick with the one who called you. When God calls you, you have peace about it. I'm just doing what God, you know, like say for instance, God called you to start a ministry. If he told you to do one service, do that one service. Until God said, listen, God told me whatever I called you to do, I'll grow it. Whatever I called you to do, outgrow it. As I spoke that, the angels of the Lord are being released over many of you all. You're going to outgrow that house. Y'all don't want to hear this in here today. It's going to be so much expansion on you. You're going to have to get a new one. Mm. You're going to outgrow the building you're in. Mm-hmm. That's the sign God is going to say, oh, it's campus number 2. Mm-hmm. Because you're going to outgrow that campus. You're going to outgrow the job you're on. To the point where the company is going to call you and say, listen, we're going to send you to our North Carolina location. We're going to send you to our Texas location. Then the Lord said, now you're going to be traveling. There's a traveler anointing on you. Why? Because your capacity for excellence have outgrown. You got to get to a point where you walk in the spirit of excellence that you outgrow it. You outgrow it. Anything you do, you outgrow it. You grow it. If you're not growing, you got to get to a point. If your pastor puts you over the singles ministry and then you get up that Sunday morning and you say, well, I want to get all people to join the singles ministry, and 10 people come down. By December 2024, the 31st, you should have outgrown that singles ministry. The pastor should be calling you in. What did you do? And I can teach you secrets on how to outgrow anything. You should start off by obeying God with 2 people. But by the end of the year, you should have outgrown it. You should have so many people showing up for the singles ministry. It will be ridiculous. They'd be like, what in the world is going on at the singles ministry? It ain't you. It's the anointing you carry. It should be so many people showing up. We should outgrow anything that God tells us to do. You outgrow it to the point where the capacity of it, you can't contain. Because increase in fruitful, I speak increase and fruitfulness upon you today. Increase in fruitfulness upon you today. I prophesy this month will be creative miracles. Someone say increase and fruitful. Someone just put in overflow. Increase, fruitfulness, and overflow. For the month of April, increase. What the 3 we said? There we go. I'm going to put thank you, Sister Linda. Then, what's Sister Linda? She put it on here. It stopped as soon as I put it on there. This thing going by so fast, I can't even see it. I tried to click on it. Sister Linda had it on here. Increase, overflow. As soon as I clicked it, it moved. It's the comments going fast, so I can't see it. There we go. Increase, Sister Williams. Increase fruitfulness and overflow. Increase. And I like the way Edmund say it. I like the way Edmund say it. He says, increase fruitfulness and supernatural overflow. Now, that's the one I'm going to grab. May the Lord give us increase, fruitfulness. Fruitful means, you know, one thing about an apple tree, it doesn't announce itself. See, some of you walk in rooms and you constantly want to announce yourself. An apple tree doesn't have to announce itself. It just keeps producing. Someone said, I will bear much fruit. We're going to bear fruit this year. You got to learn how to bear much fruit. How do you bear fruit? You stay connected to the vine. You stay connected to Jesus. You keep your eyes on Jesus. You do what God says do. You stay connected to Jesus. And I'm telling you, you will become fruitful. You will increase. And then you will walk in supernatural overflow. I prophesy this because many of you need to experience overflow. The overflow is more than enough. Psalms 23, he gives me overflow. My cup runneth over. That's overflow in the name of Jesus. I prophesy that over your month, this month, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this word that went forth in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, hallelujah, that we will see this month as we prophesy. Death and life is in the power of our tongues. You said, if we believe, we shall receive. So we prophesy over this month, increase, fruitfulness, supernatural overflow. As we increase for your glory, we will not take the credit, but we will advance your kingdom. As you increase us, we will increase your kingdom. As you give us fruitfulness, we will be effective for your kingdom. As you give us supernatural overflow, we will be effective for your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. As many of you all today, I want you to honor the Lord with April's seed, April's seed. And I want you to name your seed. This right here, increase fruitfulness and supernatural overflow. If you can put this in your comment section as you sow your seeds today. And I want you to honor the Lord with 44, 44, 144 or $44 today. Amen. As we honor the Lord with our 5 a.m. prayer seed, as we supernaturally increase, supernaturally become fruitful, supernaturally walk in overflow. And this is all for the glory of God, for where God has taken us. Amen. Amen. Let's pray over everyone that's honoring the Lord today with that 5 a.m. prayer seed. Amen. I want you to do it quickly and quietly in Jesus' name. Amen. Quickly and quietly. Increase fruitfulness and supernatural overflow in the name of Jesus as you sow today. Some of you are sowing for the month of April. The fourth month, as we honor the Lord with our seed. Amen. May the Lord bless us as we honor the Lord with our seeds. Amen. Our faith seeds in the name of Jesus. Amen. As we honor the Lord. Amen. The Lord says, give and it shall be given back to us. Pressed down, shaken together, running over. He would then cause men to pour back into our bosom. Amen. Glory be unto God. I want you to go back over those prayer decrees and begin to speak it over your life. Become the prophet over your family, the prophet over your home. Amen. Honor the Lord with that seed, $44 or $144. Amen. Glory be unto God. As you honor the Lord for the month of April, we declare creative miracles to see supernatural overflow, creative miracles to see supernatural fruitfulness. Not only you're going to be fruitful, but your ministry going to be fruitful. Your marriage is going to be fruitful. And look, that's why I have my shirt on. You got to believe to receive. You got to believe it. If you know, this is how you change the direction of your life, by speaking. Imagine if you speak this over your life every day. But today, I'm going to challenge many of you all today as you're sowing your seeds. As you're sowing your seeds, I'm challenging everyone that's on here to speak the word of God. Remember the prophet. It was by a prophet that the Lord delivered them out of Egypt. Remember, it was by my grandmama, who was a prophet, who delivered me out of that bondage that I was in. Amen. Glory be unto God. But I want you to speak the word of God morning, noon, and night. Morning, noon, and night. I was looking for the word, that scripture that we will pray morning, noon, and night. Here we go. So today I want you, if you can, quote these scriptures morning, noon, and night. Psalms 55:17, evening, morning, and noon, I will what? Pray. These are scriptures. Evening, I will pray. Morning, I will pray. Noon, I will pray. And I will cry aloud. And guess what? God is going to hear you. And he's going to continue to turn situations around for you supernaturally. Some of you think that, oh, I got to do this, I got to do it. I'm telling you the secrets. You keep your eyes on God. You speak the word. You rebuke the spirit of fear. And you believe, you will see that direction of your life begin to change. Your steps, God says, the steps of a righteous man will be ordered by the Lord. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you as you sow. God bless you as you sow. I want to speak over every person that is putting seed in the ground for the month of April. This ground is fruitful. And we speak over every person. Hallelujah. Amos 9 anointing. It won't be long. It won't be long. Many of us going to live Amos 9. I had one lady, she would sow Amos 9 for a whole year. And I wrote her and I said, why are you sowing Amos 9? She would sow that $9.13. And she would just sow it. And I said, why are you sowing the scripture? She said, because I'm going to live out Amos 9. Come testify later. This lady started living out. And that's when I started declaring Amos 9 for the rest of the year. I couldn't pass it, because when I read that scripture, it blew my mind that it won't be long. It's too long to put on here. They cut it off. It said things are going to happen so fast. Sometimes it's not about, oh, God, I need this, I need that. What scripture are you standing on? What scripture are you standing on, believing God for supernatural things in your life? I'm believing God for this. I'm believing God for that. Stand on a scripture, and I declare over your life, it won't be long. Things are going to happen so fast for you. Your head is going to swim. You won't be able to keep up, and everything will be happening all at once. And everywhere you look, blessings. All right? Is already done in Jesus' name. God has done it. Someone said, God has done it. Someone said, God, thank you for this word. God, thank you for this word. Thank you for the woman of God. Thank you, Lord God, for sending these prayers to me. Thank you, God. It's already done. It's already done. Whatever I'm believing you for is already done in Jesus' name. Amen. If you're on here and someone shared the video and invited you on and you said, listen, I want to give my life to Jesus. I want to give my life to Jesus. I really enjoyed this prayer today. I really want to give my life to Jesus. If that's you, pray this prayer after me. Say, Father, I confess that I'm a sinner. Wash me, save me, deliver me, set me free. I want you to be Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, over my life. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, welcome to the body of Christ. We pray Holy Spirit will lead you and guide you to the right church family that you begin to see and walk in the things of God. Amen. Amen. I pray that you was blessed today. Listen, we are in conference mode. This month will be the Refresh Women's Conference. We're excited. We're praying and we're fasting and seeking the Lord concerning every woman that comes through these doors. And so spend Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Sunday with us for a time of refreshing. We have powerful speakers that's coming out each night. It's for free. Every night session is for free. We have day sessions that is going to be very powerful. You don't want to miss the strategies, the art of being a woman. Why God has called us to do some powerful things in ministry and business, and how to be effective, how to begin to not sink. Don't sink, don't die in the things God has called you to be. So I want you to come out for a time of refreshing at the women's conference as we have question and answering. We will not do that at night sessions, but the day sessions, we will have question and answering. And then we will have panels that we will begin to pour into you. Then we have a prophetic pour after the day session that you'll begin to get poured into by each prophetic speaker that will be there. It will be a time of intimacy. You don't want to miss it. Thursday and Friday will be our day sessions. And so you don't want to miss it. It is still $200, amen, for the day session. And so you want to register and get registered before the seats fill up. Amen. I saw you all register very strong last week. Amen. As you continue to register, you only have a few more weeks before we cut things off because the conference is this month. So as we order these conference bags and all these things for those who register for the VIPs, as you register, that's what helps us to get your stuff. Don't wait till the last minute. Make sure you get registered to come to the Thursday session and the night, Thursday and Friday day session as the VIPs, your VIP registrants. All right. And so we're excited about it. We have more updates that's coming up. Make sure you get registered. And then also that Sunday morning as we close out the service with a powerful speaker. So listen, I'm excited about each night. Here are the flyers. Right. The first speaker for, I didn't put the other speaker on, but I'll have it on the next time. But we have Dr. Yvonne Capehart. She's coming that Thursday session. Day session. You don't want to miss her session. Make sure you get registered. You have to be registered for the day session to come in. Night sessions are free, but you have to be registered. Make sure you get registered for the day sessions. The day session starts at 11 a.m. 11 a.m. Doors open up at 10:30, but we have day sessions. All right. We have Prophetess Leslie Osei coming in for the day session as well. Friday, she's doing the Friday day session. You don't want to miss these sessions at 11 a.m. Make sure you get registered for the day sessions. All right. I'll be speaking that Friday night. I'll be speaking Thursday night. We have Prophetess. We announced her yesterday. She will be speaking the opening of the conference, the opening Wednesday night, opening of the conference. I'll be ministering Friday night. Our Prophetess Leslie will be ministering Friday night. And then that Sunday morning, we close out with Dr. Ashanti at the 12:30 service. You don't want to miss it. It's going to be powerful. Amen. We want every woman that is called to this conference, make sure you register. This is what helps us to get the flights and the hotels. We want you to partner with us. This is the first year we made it free. And we want it to be said that God has sent many sponsors. Amen. Glory be to God. And when people don't sow and don't support conferences without no money, remember, if it's free and no money, you can't bring out the best. You can't do nothing if no one is given. All right. And so we want you to sow. We want you to support this conference, that it's a kingdom move, that we don't have to charge you next year. You know how people have to charge, okay? In order to come, you got to pay for the night sessions and the day sessions. We want you all to support. So those of you who know that you can pay that $200 for the day sessions, make sure you get registered, amen, and fill it up. Fill the day sessions up. Let's sell this conference out. Let's put that in the comment section because we're going to prophesy that. Let's sell this conference out. Speak it forth. It's too many people in this world that everybody can't obey God. Everybody ain't going to tell God no. Everybody ain't going to tell God no. Let's sell this conference out with overflow, with increase, with fruitfulness. And we can't do it if we don't have women that say, listen, I want to support this kingdom move. I believe what God is doing on the inside of her. Amen. Let's all sell it out. Let's all sell it out. That means some of you get your groups and your good girlfriends and say, we all going to the day session. We taking off Thursday for the day session. We taking off Friday, but just 2 days. We taking off Thursday and Friday, and we're going to be at the day session. And there is conference packages, all that stuff. And let's get registered for the day session. You have until just like a few more weeks, and we need to go ahead and put the information in and get our stuff in, and don't wait to the last minute. Amen. Let's go ahead on and register for the day sessions. Amen. This is what gets the conference going, so we can even pay for the buildings, all these things. All right. So we got to pay for hotels for the speakers. We got to pay for a lot. And your registration helps us to pay for the end meet of that. All right. So we believe God for those who are going to register and that has already registered, even the vendors. We thank God for you. The vendor tables are filling up. All right. So we're excited about that. We're going to sell this conference out by the grace of God. We can't wait to see each. The day session starts at 11 a.m. The doors open up at 10. The doors open up at 10:30, but the day session starts at 11 a.m. And that's when we start off with the panels and question and answering women's panels and our strategy sessions. And then after this panel sessions, that's when we put the speaker up. We put the day session speaker up. It's going to be fun. And then we get that powerful ministry to end us at the day session. We got enough time to leave and go enjoy Atlanta, go get the kids from school, and come right back to the night session. All right. So I'm excited about it. We do have a new address coming soon. We're just securing the building to make sure that we can hold overflow. So we already in 400 women. So we want to make sure we have a building with the capacity to hold that many women. All right. So we're still going to be in the same area, but we're just looking, securing that spot. So make sure you get registered for the day session. And support this conference. Amen. Support the conference. All right. So the day session in person and the night session. All right. We can't wait to see you. All right. So trying to see if we have any more questions or anything. But I think that's it. All right. Well, God bless you all. We will be emailing you all with information about the day sessions. All the day sessions are VIP registrants. That means at night session, I told you it's 400 women that has registered. The only person that is coming in first is the VIPs. We will have treats for you. We will have gifts for you. We have bags for you, all that stuff, your conference bag. We have more information that will be sent out to you all, but we let the VIPs get seated first. Don't come up to me saying, oh, woman of God, I know Prophetess Fleming. If you're not a VIP, we just don't come. This is the year I delegate. Don't text me. Don't call me asking me for no seats. We have to stick to the conference program. All right. So if you paid for VIP, you will be seated in the VIP. If you don't want to sit in, don't want to sit with the VIPs, you will be sitting with the regular registrants. All right. So don't come for me, because this is a conference and we got to keep it strictly conference. So the VIPs will have the preferred seating in the front. All right. And then the conference registrants will sit behind the VIPs. These are people who helped us fund the conference, who helped us get the conference speakers rooms. And if you're on here and you say, listen, I want to be a partner to your conference, I love the fact that you're opening it up for free. That means anybody can come, whether they give or not. But I want to be a conference sponsor. That means I want to sow 1,000. I want to sow 3,000. I want to sow 10,000. I want to sow for the building. I want to pay for the building. I want to pay for the speakers' hotels. I want to pay for the rental car to pick up them from the airport. You know, I want to be a conference sponsor. If that's you, reach out to us to our website and make sure you partner with us and say, hey, I want to make sure this conference is a success. I want to sow into this conference, and I want to make sure that they continue to do the will of God that represents the kingdom of God. Amen. Glory be unto God. When the world does things, Beyonce, all them people have to pay $100 tickets, all kind of tickets to get in that building. No one gets in there for free. And so with the kingdom of God, we want to make sure people get the good news and the gospel without charging them to come in. But we have to have sponsors in order to do big things for the kingdom of God. And so if you see a person who walks in the spirit of excellence, they have partners. Partners are people who sow monthly, or people who have came and said, hey, here's a check for the ministry. Here's a check for this to do God's will so you can continue to do it. Amen. So I'm excited about what God is doing. And we thank God for you. I want to thank God for every sponsor. I want to thank you in advance for every sponsor, every person that is saying, hey, I want to hold your hands for this ministry. And I don't want you and your family to be burdened for doing God's will. Amen. Glory be unto God. So we thank God for your support, for your help, and for your prayers. Amen. So we're excited about it. It's this month. And God is going to be pleased, and we're excited about it. We're bringing out the best musicians to you. You have to pay for these things. No one is coming for free. That's the crazy thing about it. Nobody coming for free, but we do have the conference open for free for those who are coming. So we need sponsors, and those of you who register for the day session is going to help us tremendously to take care of the conference before that day. All right. So I'll see you all again. God bless you all. This is the conference link to register for the women's conference. Where is the women's conference flyer? Here we go. That's the conference flyer. April, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And then we'll see you that Sunday. So make sure you go on Eventbrite. And where's the Eventbrite link? Let me get that to you right here. Eventbrite. We do have room blocks. Let me say that for those who are coming out of town. We do have room blocks. First of all, let me find this Eventbrite link while I do all this talking, because I don't see it. Thank y'all got it. I got so much on my phone. Okay, here you go. There we go. We do have room blocks. If you want to stay in one of the hotels with the conference name, Refresh, they have given us a discount on these hotels. If you want that, we have it on the Eventbrite. You just click on that and it takes you to the link there. If you don't see it, we'll email it to you. So that's the link to get registered on Eventbrite, or you can just go to my website. It should be, you click on the flyer takes you right to Eventbrite to get registered. If you don't see it, just always inbox the website, and we will make sure we get all this details to you. All right. So we do have room blocks, and I believe that's it for the women's conference. So we're excited. Can't wait to see you. God bless you. All right. God bless you. Shout your city and your state out. We're praying and fasting for you today. God bless you. I see someone just registered for the conference. Let's go see who that is. God bless you. Who just registered? I just saw a name popped up for Eventbrite. Here we go. God bless you, Sister Williams. Just registered 2 tickets to the Refresh Women's Conference. God bless you. God bless you, Sister Williams. So we can't wait to see you at the Refresh Women's Conference. All right. So don't forget, we can't wait to see you at the day sessions and the night sessions. All right. God bless you all. Can't wait to see you. God bless each and every last one of you. Your contribution to help us to do this Women's Conference. The Bible says you have not because you ask not. And so I can't wait to see you all there. The vendors, we have a nice space for you all to set up. You'll be exposed to over 400 women and men and children that's coming to this conference. Make sure that before it gets cut off, we only can take but so many vendors. But make sure you get exposed, and we're gonna declare that we sell you all out. We sell out the vendors and support the vendors as they come to this women's conference. It's gonna be an amazing weekend, a weekend of fun, and we can't wait to see you. All right, God bless you all. God bless you all. God bless you all. God bless you all.